Now, getting started in network marketing, a lot of people think, oh my God, what am I going to do? I've got to write a list, I've got to do this. Who am I going to call? How do I duplicate what someone else is doing? Oh, that person's a salesman, I couldn't sell stuff. Don't worry about any of that. That's not how you start in network marketing. Network marketing, now I've been reading a lot again recently, and I've been listening to and reading stuff by Randy Gage. And the most important thing is to make sure that you have a duplicatable system that is not reliant on any one particular person. It's something that everybody could do. And getting started, the first thing is you've got to get your mindset right. You've got to get your mind in the right place. Now, I, in the past, have written and done a lot of videos on mindset in general things, business, but with network marketing, the first thing you've got to know is you've got to know what is your dream. Not just your goals, what is your dream? Because network marketing and MLM is all about reclaiming your dreams back from the corporate world and the rat race. It's getting back to where, what do you want to really achieve? What's the lifestyle that you want? Do you want to spend time with your family and your kids? Do you want to spend time traveling? What is it that you want to do? Or do you just want to work, you know, and give all your time away to charity? And know that you've still got an income coming in so you can do what you want to do and support the networks and people you want to. That's what I want to do, to an extent. So the first thing, mindset. Know your dreams and realise that this isn't something that's, it's not a get rich quick scheme. Have a 2 to 4 year plan. Aim to stick at this for 2 to 4 years. Now if you are starting a normal business, normal and self-employed, and you're going to grow your own business, it's not going to grow up over 6 months or 3 months or 9 months or a year. It could take 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years. So don't give up at the first hurdle. Expect it to take 2 to 4 years for an income to actually come in. And realise that you're only doing this part-time, most likely, and sometimes even really part-time. And the more part-time you are, and the less serious you are about doing this on a daily basis, the longer it will take. So don't get disheartened. Just realise it's a process and it takes time, and just follow the systems in place. So, looking at my notes, yes. Second thing is, yeah, after making a plan, just realise that your competition, don't try and go after other people in other network marketing businesses. Don't try and prove to them that your business is better than their business. Realise that the competition is really the corporate world and the rat race. That's the competition. That's who you're competing with. That's where you want to find people, because there are millions and millions of people that have never heard of network marketing or tried it in any way, and then just looking for something different to do. Yeah. Operate on the fringe of fear. I got that from Randy Gage. That's a great phrase. So it's instead of out of the box or something like that, operate on the fringe of fear. If you want to be a little bit nervous, you want to challenge yourself a little bit, because with network marketing, personal growth is directly related to business growth. And unless you're sort of challenging yourself at all, you're not going to grow as a business or a person. And because you are the business in network marketing, if you grow yourself, the business will grow with you. So always look at trying to do things that you're maybe not too comfortable with. It's a little bit fearful. Is this the right thing? Just keep on going for it. Keep on going for it. Ask for advice from your sponsors, your upline. Yeah, getting back to the system that's duplicatable. That's it. So, I mean, if you're a great salesperson, I mean, brilliant. You're going to sell a lot of stuff. But a lot of people really don't like selling. 90% of people really don't like selling, and they think, I can never do that. But luckily, this business is more about teaching than selling. It's about teaching people about the products. It's about teaching people what to say, what to do. It's about teaching people about the actual business opportunity rather than trying to sell some fantastic product. So if you are a salesperson, great. You can teach sales skills to people who want to learn them, but it's more about being teachable and being able to teach. So don't worry about selling. This is not a selling business. Selling isn't so duplicatable. Teaching is much more duplicatable and can be learnt. And finally, the fourth thing basically is, yeah, there are lots of things out there in the world, like how to find lots of and sponsor people, you know, thousands and thousands of people online, and there's all sorts of ways of contacting lots of people and getting people in quick, and if you do search online, you'll find downline building clubs, all sorts of things. But this becomes very impersonal. And this means that as soon as the next opportunity comes along that looks better to these people that have been signed up through this automatic system, they're going to leave and go elsewhere. This is really about developing relationships with people, lifelong relationships, so that they'll be loyal to you, they'll be loyal to the product, they'll be loyal to the company, they'll stick with you. Because the idea is you want to build this once and get paid forever. So you want to be surrounded with the sorts of people and the sort of business partners. Who do you want to spend, you know, the next 10, 20, 30 years working with? You want good, solid people, people you know, like, and trust. So look around you at the moment. Look at your 10 closest friends. This is another interesting little fact. Apparently, your income is usually based about the average of your 10 closest friends. So look at your 10 closest friends. If you know their income, fantastic. And your income will probably be the average of their 10. So if you want to earn money, more money, you can basically either find 10 richer friends, or you can work on developing some of your closest friends maybe in this business as well, and so that they earn more money, and so you earn more money as well. Because your friends, you know, maybe you want to work with them, maybe there's things to do with them as well. So look at your closest friends, look at your warm market, as it were. And look at developing them and or finding other people like them that you know, like, and trust. Okay, so that's how to get started. I'll be back again with more stuff later.